So there you are, riding down the road, having a good day, minding your own business. Then all of a sudden, four lights come on, you get the chime, and you wonder, what in the world is wrong with my car? We're gonna go through these lights, four lights coming on at one time. Sometimes that can be a good thing, sometimes be a bad thing, but most of the time, it's something that's actually very minor. Now, the light that probably concerns people the most is gonna be the red brake light in the middle. Depending on your type of car, it can mean many different things. It could be low brake fluid, and many times with a red brake light, this could be a big deal. So it's something you really want to be careful of. If you're at highway speeds, try to pull over somewhere safe, obviously, and if you don't feel comfortable driving the car, pull over somewhere, have it checked out, check your own brake fluid. You can also feel in the brakes if it feels spongy or something like that, then you realize something actually is wrong. In my case, I was on my way to a red light. So I turned the cruise control off, hit the brakes a couple times. There was nobody behind me, but I didn't hit the brakes real hard. I felt the brakes, they felt okay. Slowed all the way down to a stop at the stoplight. So I continued on home. I felt like everything was fine. So we'll look at the lights from left to right. All the way to the left is ABS, anti-lock braking system. Not too big of a deal. That light comes on. That just means you don't have anti-lock brakes. So it's like an old school car. Just be careful, don't slam on the brakes real hard in the rain. When we already talked about the red light in the middle is brake, could mean numerous things. The third light is hill assist, and that is because this car has a computer shifted manual transmission. So if you're on a hill, it senses that. It'll automatically apply the brakes so that you won't roll down the hill whenever you take your foot off the brake and then go to push the gas. Then the last one all the way to the right is traction control. Now when four lights, or any car that has multiple lights that all come on at the same time, more than likely this is going to be one issue caused all these lights. So next, with the way modern day cars are with computers and sensors, you really need to know what's going on with your car. So what I use as a great DIY tool is called Blue Driver. Now what this does is, this is a sensor that you put into your OBD2 port in your car, and it links up with your smartphone, and it gives you all the codes, it gives you all kinds of data. I'm not going to go through everything because it's tons of data. But the good thing is, this saves you a lot of money, because you buy this sensor, your phone, you already have the technology needed to have a scan tool. It's just obviously your smartphone doesn't have a way to connect to the car. So this connects to the car. And then Blue Driver, once you order this, Blue Driver updates the system on a regular basis, and they're using the technology of your phone so that they don't have to constantly come out with new electronics, build a whole scan tool, anything like that. So it saves you some money. So you want to go to the App Store and download the Blue Driver app. Once you get there, click on it. This is the iPhone version. You'll see at the bottom left where it says Order Sensor. Click on that, you'll see the screen. You have two options. You can buy on Amazon or buy in the app. Click on buy on Amazon if you have an Amazon account. Pretty self-explanatory. Add to cart, $119.95. Of course, they're going to charge you taxes, shipping, whatever. Or you can order straight from the app. And it has a couple different ways to pay. Apple Pay, Shop Pay, PayPal, whatever. It only took about 3 or 4 days for me to get the sensor in the mail. And once this handy dandy little sensor comes in the mail, you're gonna put it up under the dash wherever your OBD2 port is on your car. Blue light's gonna start blinking. Open your phone, open the app on your phone, hit connect, and it connects all by itself. Put in your VIN number, this and that, whatever, read your codes. Now let's move on to what is wrong with this car. After checking brake fluid, making sure it was full, it is, and checking for leaks all the way around, brakes feel great, I believe more likely it's gonna be a sensor. So once we hook Blue Driver up to the car, it comes up with these codes. As you can see, we have a C003A right rear wheel speed sensor. It's got a signal failure. You always wanna remember that one. If it points out a specific sensor, it might be a good place to start. And then we have the other three codes. Not gonna read them all to you. You can read them. Invalid data, another control module type of failure. Now what we're going to do is we're going to check the speed sensor, because modern cars now have a wheel speed sensor for all four wheels. So if something happens, you get a broken wire, you get a bad sensor at any one of these, it's going to set off the code saying that the speed sensor is bad, and probably because it's not receiving a speed. So you got three tires going 55 miles an hour and you got one tire that's zero. Then the computer realizes there's some sort of issue, and what it's going to do is it's going to cause all these other lights to come on. It's going to make the brake light come on because now you're not going to have ABS. It turns off ABS system, turns off hill assist system, and it turns off the traction control, because the computer does not have valid data telling it the speed of all four tires. So the first thing we're going to do is remove this tire. You have your brake fluid line. When you push the brake, this pressurizes, pushes fluid all the way down here to the brake. This is old school. It's got drums, a little cheap car. You have parking brake cable. So this isn't going to be the issue. That's not going to be the issue. Then you have a wire with a connector right here. This wire comes all the way around. And the sensor is actually housed inside of here. You have one little bolt right there. Remove that bolt, and then this sensor pulls out. Now, most cars today, you have to buy the entire hub. So the sensor is integrated inside the hub assembly. So you take your brake assembly off, and then usually it's three or four bolts on a front-wheel drive car like this to do the rear. It's real simple. You just have three or four bolts back here in the back. Take those bolts out, buy a new hub assembly, put the new one on. It'll have a wire sticking out. You connect the wire back, and it's no issue. You hook the wire back, and the job is done. This car, being a little economical car, is even easier than that. If you had to replace the sensor, all you would do, remove that bolt, like I said, pull that sensor out, disconnect the wire at this point, at the top, and replace it. So the first thing we're going to do is, and you could, no matter what style you have, if you have an individual sensor or if you have to replace the entire wheel hub with a sensor inside, you can do this. We're going to disconnect it here, right here at this connector, and we're going to check for corrosion. So I just use two hands, one grab the bottom, and then the other one grab the top, push in the tab. Now once you get the cable disconnected, you want to look inside, and you'll see two little pins inside there. You want to check for corrosion on those. This car wasn't really that bad. You can clean it up and see if that works. If you don't have the money to replace the sensor, sometimes that may be the problem. You also want to look in the other end, make sure there's no issues. This one looked just fine. And then you also want to look at the wires, make sure there's no breaks in the wires anywhere. These wires are protected pretty well all the way through. Some cars, you'll have a little bit of anti-chafe tape on there, and you can just pull the tape off and look at the wires. But more times than not, if you don't see anything obvious, no broken wires, no corrosion, it's just going to be the sensor. So in this car, pretty cheap, you buy the sensor and replace it. Once you get the new sensor, put everything in place, hook it back together, take it for a test drive. Now, something you definitely want to do is when you get everything back together, make sure your connector is nice and secure. You might even want to put some dielectric grease inside there. Keep moisture out. Keep it from having issues in the future. But then you have all these points here, these little keepers and all. When you pull the old wire out, you're going to pull out all these keepers. It's very important to push these right back in place where they need to be. The engineers, very smart people, figured out where the keepers need to be to keep everything out of the way. As you see, this wire doesn't just run straight down to the hub down here. You got a keeper there, wire comes around, got a keeper there, and it comes all the way around to the back of the hub here. It's all for a reason. That is so you can have the proper suspension travel, and for the most part, it protects it in case rocks or anything hit. Won't destroy the cable the very first time, hopefully. But it's all for a reason. So you want to put all that stuff back correctly. Double check yourself, because you don't want to have to do this again. Now, as far as sensors, I'll always go to Ford. I go to the Ford dealership first because it's local and I can get the part real fast. If they're not charging an outrageous amount of money, which a lot of times now they're not because they know there's a lot of online competition, I'll go ahead and buy the sensor from the local dealership. Now, if the sensor is bad to the point to where it's never working anymore, it doesn't, the computer's not receiving any readings from it at all, and you do the same drive every day, you can pretty much tell, okay, at this stoplight, the lights are all gonna come back on. And if that happens, more than likely, it's the sensor itself is bad. Now, if it's intermittent to where sometimes the warning lights come on at this stoplight, but then the next drive, it takes 10 miles down the road to get down there, then you could have some corrosion, possibly corrosion in there causing a little bit of a bad connection, and you can just check that out. Like I said, you disconnect it, check for corrosion, clean it if you want to, and if you have no means to fix it at all, check the corrosion, the brakes and the wires and things like that. And if you have done all that and you still can't find the issue where you think it might be a sensor and you have no money to fix it at all, keep driving. You're not gonna have ABS, not gonna have hill assist, traction control, so drive your car very careful. But if you have brake fluid, the brakes feel fine, it stops fine, then it's not gonna be a big issue. This is something that you can drive with your car. It's not gonna hurt the car, it's not gonna hurt anything, it's not any more unsafe. Now there's people that's gonna say, well, it's a little more unsafe because you don't have ABS. No, if you don't drive like a maniac and slam on the brakes in the middle of the rain or something like that, then your car is not gonna skid out of control. I mean, let's face it, a lot of us can remember a day when no cars had ABS. So if this happens to you, you always wanna drive careful. You wanna drive careful every day anyway. Everybody calm down, quit driving like a bat out of hell. But just be careful with the car, save up your money until you get to the point to where you can fix it. It's not a big deal. So there you have it, another easy fix. But that is if you want to do it. If you don't want to do the work, I suggest you at least get the Blue Driver tool so that you can check it out yourself when you take it to a mechanic, so you'll have the knowledge and you'll know what's going on. Because dishonest mechanic, unfortunately, you see all four of those lights, especially if you look like you're scared, nervous, don't know what's wrong with the car, they could take you for a ride and charge you for all kind of extra repairs that you don't need. So in this case, if you want to take it to a mechanic, you put the Blue Driver on it, you look at it, you scan it, you look at your phone, you see it's a right rear wheel speed sensor, you can go straight to them and say, I got four lights that came on, this is disabled, this is disabled, I got a code for the right rear wheel speed sensor, and then have them go from there. A little bit of knowledge could show them that, hey, we're not going to be able to take this person for a ride, not going to be able to take their money, not going to be able to lie to them, whatever. You always want to have that knowledge. Now there are cheaper scan tools, but Blue Driver gives you all types of other information that you'll probably see in a future video if the need arises. And I have not been able to find a better scan tool for the price. But I want to say thank you to all the supporters. Thank you for liking, subscribing, and just watching this video. Leave a comment in the section below if you do something a little different or if you just want to talk. Be safe, and as always, have a great day.